At Wigmore Hall, we are now reaching a global audience through our live streams, connecting exceptional artists with music lovers in homes all over the world. Now audiences everywhere can experience the vital and unifying power of music from this most intimate hall in London. Each of these broadcasts requires at least £3,000 in addition to regular concert costs. We want to make sure they remain available for free to everyone. If you are able to, please help us by donating each time you watch. What makes Wigmore Hall special is the sense of community it inspires, and this continues to thrive thanks to the spirit of your generosity. Please support us today. Your gifts are making all the difference.
Thank you very much indeed, Ian. Hello and welcome to Wigmore Hall for today's lunchtime recital live on Radio 3, for which the Doric String Quartet will be joined by the viola-playing composer whose music they premiered, Brett Dean. Today, though, he's the second viola in a strangely neglected masterpiece, the only work Beethoven composed specifically for the medium, his String Quintet in C, Opus 29. Before that, though, the quartet play Haydn, who in 1784 wrote to the Viennese music publishers Artaria, accepting an offer of 300 florins for six new string quartets, though it was 3 years before he completed the set that was to become known as Opus 50. He dedicated them to King Frederick William II of Prussia, nephew of Frederick the Great, and one of the most notable patrons of music in 18th century Germany. He was also a keen amateur cellist and collected chamber music with prominent cello parts. Haydn didn't, though, respond to writing for Frederick William by giving him concerto-like moments, which would have weakened the spare, concentrated musical architecture of his Opus 50 quartets. It was the first set Haydn had published for 5 years and eagerly anticipated by chamber music enthusiasts all over Europe. Number 5 in F major is the lightest and most genial of the set, sophisticated though it is. The main weight of the quartet is in the two middle movements, the serene, slow movement with its undulating, lulling chords with gentle dissonances below a rhapsodic violin line, which spawned the quartet's nickname of The Dream. The following minuet is sinewy and restless before the charming, jolly finale. And so here now come the members of the Doric Quartet onto the Wigmore Hall stage. Alex Reddington and Ying Shui violins, Hélène Clément viola, John Myersko cello, to perform Haydn's Quartet in F major, Opus 50, number 5.
Thank you. Thank you.
String Quartet in F major, opus 50, number 5, ending with a positively rakish finale, and Alex Reddington, the first violin's dancing feet, I couldn't help noticing from my position right by the side of the stage. One of the set Haydn dedicated to the cello-playing King Frederick Wilhelm II of Prussia. I wonder if he ever took part in that quartet. Performed here at Wigmore Hall in London and live on Radio 3 by the Doric Quartet. Really vigorous playing, throwing themselves into it, but lots of smiles, real enjoyment too. And I think that might be some of their students in the Royal Academy, if you can hear some whoops going on. Critics have often heard the influence of Mozart in Haydn's Opus 50 quartets. They'd just become friends, making music together at that famous quartet party when Haydn and Dittersdorf played violins, Mozart, viola and Van Hal cello. They all played together in a friend's Viennese apartment. And shortly afterwards, Haydn told Leopold Mozart his son was the greatest composer he knew, and Mozart dedicated his new quartets to Haydn, entrusting them to the protection and guidance of a highly celebrated man and my dearest friend. Well, now Brett Dean joins the quartet as the extra viola for a performance of Beethoven's String Quintet in C major, opus 29. His sole work originally conceived for the quintet medium, which he composed in 1801. It's something of a neglected masterpiece, and one of those works from a period of Beethoven's life when his music looks both backwards and forwards. He didn't directly model it in any of Mozart's string quintets, but he never wrote a more voluptuously Mozartian slow movement than here. On the other hand, the spaciousness and harmonic flexibility of the quintet's first movement looks to the future, prompted by the added richness and variety of texture created by the second viola. Beethoven composed the quintet at a time when he was becoming acutely aware of the onset of his deafness, and if the first two movements are mostly genial and good-natured in their flowing expression, the last two become sterner, more energetic and driven, seeming to come from a different, more disquieting world. Did Beethoven perhaps begin to experience the anxiety and depression associated with his condition midway through writing the work? Well, the stage has been reset, so we have a fifth chair for our second viola, Brett Dean. Australian composer, viola player and conductor, and he was born in the year his compatriot Percy Grainger died, 1961. Having played viola in the Berlin Philharmonic for some 14 years, Brett Dean moved back to Australia to concentrate on his composing. He's now one of the most performed composers of our time. Here he comes, together with the Doric Quartet. Alex Reddington and Ying Shui violins, Ellen Clement viola and John Myersko cello to perform Beethoven's String Quintet in C, Opus 29.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Finale with explosive shimmers and whirling fragmentary tunes, complete with lightning flashes. No wonder German-speaking countries give it the nickname Der Sturm, the Storm. Beethoven's String Quintet in C major, Opus 29, performed here at Wigmore Hall and live on Radio 3 by the Doric String Quartet, Alex Reddington and Ying Shui violins, Hélène Clément, viola and John Myersco cello, with Brett Dean playing the second viola part. Doric Quartet returning to the stage now, celebrating their quarter century this year. And they won first prize at the 2008 Osaka International Chamber Music Competition. No wonder in February they're heading back to Japan for a tour. They'll be in Antwerp on Wednesday, playing this programme with Brett Dean's third quartet as well, Hidden Agendas. Start of February recording a Beethoven quartet cycle, more of that. And if you're around in Seton on the 9th of February, you can hear them playing Haydn, Smetana and Berg, and the same programme on the 17th of February in Leamington Spa. Back they come. Hélène Clément quite near me. I'm looking at her viola, which was previously owned and played by both Frank Bridge and his pupil, a certain Benjamin Britten. Brett Dean just slotting in. Well, obviously, they know his music and he knows their work. beaming smile. Well, next Monday's lunchtime concert here at Wigmore Hall, live on Radio 3, features the charismatic mezzo-soprano Léa Desandre, who's joined by the Jupiter Ensemble for an all-baroque programme taken from their multi-award-winning 2021 album Amazzone, and including music by Cavalli, Marais, Philidor and Vivaldi. Should be more enthralling music-making. I hope you'll join us for it just after 1 o'clock, a week today.